Hi, you probably know calculators like this one. If you look at the buttons, you see that it can evaluate a lot of functions that you're familiar with. But if you zoom in on the electronics behind these buttons, you will find that at a very elementary level, it can only perform two mathematical operations exactly, addition and multiplication. This may seem very limited, but using only these, there's already a large class of functions that you can construct, the so-called polynomial functions. To be more precise, polynomial functions are functions that can be constructed from a variable and a set of numbers using only addition and multiplication. Let's look at an example. Suppose our function takes x as input. We can raise it to the fifth power, since this is just repeated multiplication, then add minus 1, multiply by 2x plus 3, and then finally add 1/2 times x. This is an example of a polynomial function. The expression that defines the function is called a polynomial. The expression looks a bit messy. There's a standard way to simplify polynomials. How does this work? First, get rid of the brackets by expanding the product. Remember how to do this. You take all possible products of terms in the first factor with the terms in the second factor, and then add those products. So in this case, you get 4 terms from the expansion, and the term 1/2 times x was already there. After this, combine the terms with the same power of x. And finally, make sure that the terms are ordered from highest power to lowest power. This is already the case in the last expression. The final expression that we found is called the standard form of this polynomial. In general, the standard form of a polynomial looks like this: a sum of terms, and each term is a product of a number and x raised to some integer power. The terms are ordered from high power to low. Note that the powers of x are positive integers. Division by x is not allowed. The a's are called the coefficients. These coefficients can also be negative and can also be fractions. In fact, they can be any real number. A polynomial can always be put into standard form by following the simplification procedure that I sketched earlier. Get rid of brackets, gather the terms with the same power of x, and order the terms from high power to low power. An important property of a polynomial is its degree. It is defined as the highest power that occurs in the standard form. Be aware, you have to look at the standard form. For example, the expression on the screen is a polynomial that's not in standard form. What is its degree? You might say 6, since that's the highest power that occurs, but that's not correct. First, rewrite it to standard form. If you simplify, you find that the terms containing x to the power 6 cancel. The highest occurring power is 5, so that's degree. I invite you to check the calculation yourself. Why is the degree so important? One answer is that it provides information about the behavior of a polynomial function when x becomes large. For example, consider the polynomial function px equal to 2 times x cubed plus 8 times x squared minus 13x. You can see in the table that as x grows larger, the first term grows fastest. For x very large, the first term will be much larger than the other terms. So then, the function roughly behaves as 2 times x cubed, which is a power function. That is, the relative difference becomes very small. In a similar way, when x becomes much smaller than 0, the relative difference between px and 2x cubed also becomes very small. In general, we have the following. Given some polynomial function of degree n, then for x values much larger than 0 or much smaller than 0, it will be roughly equal to the power function an times x to the power n. The exponent of this power function is precisely the degree of the polynomial. In the next video, you will learn more about the relation between the degree of a polynomial and its behavior. Let me end with a final remark on the calculator that I started with. Given the basic mathematical operations that it can perform, addition and multiplication, it follows that a calculator is very good at evaluating polynomial functions. But most calculators can do much more. There are buttons for sine and cosine, logarithms, square roots, etc. How can a calculator evaluate those? And the answer is, it cannot. But using polynomials, these functions can be approximated. More about that in the university preview of this week.